Congratulations, you're pregnant. But wait, what about that Disney trip you had planned? Should you cancel it? No! There are still lots of ways to have lots of fun at either Disney resort in the United States. I've wanted to do this video since the beginning of my YouTube career 2 years ago, but I wanted to wait until I could be qualified and experienced enough to do it, because otherwise, like, who am I to give you advice if I've never gone to Disneyland pregnant? But I have gone twice now, so you can trust me now. First of all, to start off, let's discuss what rides, according to the Walt Disney Company, it is advised not to ride these rides at all. First of all, be sure to talk to your doctor to make sure you can ride any of the rides that are supposedly safe, but these are the ones, too, according to Disney, that are recommended, not for expectant mothers. There are some doctors, too, that say you can ride anything in your first trimester, but don't take my word for it, please. Please talk to your doctor or midwife first. At Disneyland Resort, expectant moms should not ride Autopia, Big Thunder Mountain, Gadget's Go Coaster, Indiana Jones, Matterhorn Bobsleds, Space Mountain, and Splash Mountain. If you are going to California Adventure, expectant mothers should not ride Incredicoaster, Goofy Sky School, Grizzly River Run, Guardians of the Galaxy Mission Breakout, Mater's Junkyard Jamboree, or Radiator Springs Racers. Now, if you're going to Disney World in Florida, expectant mothers should not ride Splash Mountain, Big Thunder Mountain, Space Mountain, Barnstormer, Seven Dwarfs Mine Train, Tomorrowland Speedway, and Magic Kingdom. In Epcot, you shouldn't ride Test Track or Mission Space. At Disney's Hollywood Studios, you shouldn't ride Tower of Terror, Rock and Roller Coaster, Slinky Dog Dash, or Star Tours. At Animal Kingdom, you should not ride Flight of Passage, Expedition Everest, Dinosaur, Cali River Rapids, Kilimanjaro Safari, or Primeval World. That's all the rides. There's still lots of fun stuff to do at Animal Kingdom. Oh no, you can ride Navi in River Journey. Sorry. Okay, I got off topic. Now let's talk about some tips to make sure that you have a comfortable, fun, incident-free experience at the parks. Number one, bring snacks. You're gonna be hungry / nauseous or whatever, so be sure to bring your own snacks, things that you know you can keep down or things that you know you enjoy or might want, and that might save you a bit of money too. Be sure to take as many breaks as you need, prepare to take it slow, and maybe even be prepared to go back to the hotel and take a nap whenever you want. And maybe be prepared to watch lots of shows instead of focusing on rides. Most women feel best during their second trimester of pregnancy, so that is when I would recommend going to the parks. If you want, you can rent a wheelchair at any of the parks, but it is first come, first serve, so if you're worried about not getting it, be sure to decide before you get to the park that you want it and get it. If not, you still might, if you decide halfway through the day, you still might be able to get a wheelchair. I just can't guarantee that. If you're going to Disney World in Florida, it might be wise to avoid purchasing a Disney dining plan just because you are very limited to the options that they give you, first of all. And second of all, you have to eat at certain places at certain times, which pregnant women, that doesn't really work for us. You just have more freedom to eat when you want, where you want, if you go just bringing money set aside for food instead of the Disney dining plan ahead of time. It's also a really fun time and something that you might not be able to do again, so be sure to take lots of pictures to document the fun and your bump. This is so important, especially no matter which park you're going to, but especially in Florida because it's so hot and humid basically year-round, is drink lots of water. I bring a hydro, a very fat hydro, and I fill it up with cold water throughout the day, which water is free around the parks. Be sure to ask a cast member where you can get free filtered water, and they can show you the nearest filling station, and you can fill up your hydro all day, and then the hydro will keep it cool for 24 hours or whatever. So do that if you are able. It's also important to stay cool because we get so warm. It feels so hot all the time when you're pregnant. So bring a cooling towel if you have one. Try and stay indoors as much as possible. Bring a portable fan or umbrella. Do whatever you can to just keep cool. All right, well, that's all I have. Like, it's gonna be so much fun. I really think you should still go if you think you will feel up to it. And if your doctor or midwife gives you the okay, it's definitely still fun. And if it's your first baby, it's fun to go just you and your partner before the baby gets there and before everything changes. Be sure to hit the like button, the comment button, the subscribe button, the notification bell button, the share button. Click the links in the description below to follow my social medias and get my books. Thanks again for watching. See you real soon.